Hey, what's up, y'all? I just have to make a quick video because something just really hit me just a few minutes ago, and I just wanted to say something about it. And I just had a quick, I'll say, recollection of something that happened a few years ago here online. I remember when I first started to doing any kind of marketing online, whereas you had certain companies who kind of be very picky about who they let into their, you know, into their sites, and you know, just a few things that was happening that really kind of made me look back and say, wow, who would have thought, who would have think those companies would no longer exist. Instead of saying that, I was just on Facebook and I saw a group that I wanted to join, and they had some stipulations. And I was like to myself, you have a stipulation for someone to join your group and say that make sure you read this and make sure you read that and before you join the group. Now, that kind of bothered me because first and foremost, you don't own Facebook. So I know why you're putting stipulation. I can understand if it's an adult site. That's something different. That should not be on Facebook anyway, but they do exist. And I have a problem with that. You know, if you're going to put up a Facebook page, something that was given to you for free, yes, I understand Facebook give us the option to make a closed group or an open group, and you know, you can let whoever you want in there. But I just have a problem with those type of things. Certain groups, yes, I can understand, you know, sometimes you have, you know, sensitive information, you know, maybe some course that it's trying to sell. And that's understandable. But I remember, I'm not sure how long you've been online, whoever's watching this video, but if you've been doing any type of marketing online, then you remember when e-zine articles was like the top dog online for article submission. And I remember clearly starting out and everybody saying, yo, go to e-zine articles, post your articles in e-zine article because they're like, you know what I'm saying? Your article is going to shut up top of the search engine once for your chosen keyword. And yeah, for a long time, that was the case. I'm serious. That was the case. You could post an article on Easy an article, and that baby would rank, you know. But they got greedy. They got greedy. They got picky. They start to feel like they're the man. But guess what? The big G, the big Google. They no longer Easy an articles is like. People still submit articles there, but they no longer the top dog online. They no longer have the clout, or they no longer have the clout is a good word for that, to demand or to restrict or to. I'm sure they're probably over there dying for people to come submit articles on their sites. You go there right now, you see a lot of articles on, especially on real estate or loan modifications or loans. A lot of those sites are dead. A lot of those links are dead. Those sites exist no more. So there's a lot of dead links pointing, or a lot of articles on Easy Article that have a lot of dead links in them. All right. So people are still submitting, but article base is there. I mean, they do what they got to do. I'm not sure why people submit articles over there, but. You know, going back to the whole Facebook thing, you know, that's just to show you that Facebook is huge and people, a lot of people on Facebook right now. But remember when MySpace was a top dog. Everybody was on MySpace. MySpace was the place to be. Now, MySpace is no longer the place to be. Yes, I'm sure it's making money still, but it's not where it was back in the day. So I just wanted to make that video because I just felt away trying to go to this group and I saw the stipulation. I'm like, yo, you just can't be doing that. You know, if you create a group, let people sign up. Don't put no stipulation, hey, this and hey, that. You know, Facebook don't have to keep your little page. They could take that on the heartbeat. One click and that page is gone. All right? So I'm not here to bash anybody. I'm just saying, just look at what can happen. Another site that got, you know, just got killed out of nowhere. One day there was like a message and every single page was gone. There were millions of pages on the site. You guys may not remember Squidoo. Squidoo was another site that was huge back in the day. When I say big, but they were a little lax and people were just creating spam pages all over the place. Spam pages with no real value, pages just promoting crap. All right, and they were starting to clamp down on people who were posting nonsense, people were posting junk on their site. And eventually, I'm not sure you guys remember, their message started hitting people's inbox that they started locking sites down. They started locking pages down. All of a sudden, you go to your page and there's a lock. You can't access your page for nothing. So a lot of people who were making a lot of money in Squidoo, and I blame that on the industry, the affiliate marketing industry, because them guys were just putting out nothing but junk and they made it bad for everybody else. And then they decided to kind of clamp down on all the junk that was spewing out of there. But by the time they get around to doing that, it was too late. So they migrated some of the information over to another site. I forgot what name of the site is. Top of my head right now. I guess those quote-unquote top dogs that was in Squidoo was making all the money. They transferred all their content over to that site. And then from there, Google slapped that site. When I say slapped, it got slapped really hard. Pages was disappearing out of search engines. You can't find no pages. I think they were losing money like crazy. I could be wrong, but for them to shut the site down, I'm sure they had a lot of employees and things probably wasn't looking good over there. So eventually that site got shut down. That site was owned by Seth Godin. And, you know, I can just say that, you know, sites that either was once free or they gave people access to the sites free. And then you have these people going in, you know, kind of either abusing the system or they create pages with all these stipulations. And then people start acting like, you know, they're the boss, or sometimes they forget that they started out just like everybody else, you know, from ground up. Sometimes people forget sometimes. But, you know, as I said, I'm not here to bash anybody. I just wanted to talk about that because that just hit me for a minute. And I just wanted to make this quick video. And again, the web, you know, I love you guys. Again, if you're going to create a page on Facebook, man, just kind of lay off on the stipulations, you know, do what you got to do, make it open to the public. And, you know, let's just all have fun because Facebook, you know, as I said, nothing lasts forever, man. It's on top right now doing this thing and I love it. You know, I'm on there, I'm doing my thing, my family, friends, running my business on Facebook. Because right now it's a gold mine for traffic for any business to be, and just to get a handle on things. All right, so again, thank you guys for watching my video, man, and hope you guys like it, hope you guys share it, and you know, subscribe to my channel. And you know, I'm glad you guys are here, and just do what y'all do, man. Make it big, make your business grow. If you're marketing online, if you kind of trying to start your business, if you're already in your business and kind of growing it and looking to, you know, divest, more power to you. If you're just thinking about starting and you want to, you know, learn how to get started, or, you know, you're really looking into starting an online business or work from home opportunity, you know, reach out to me, man. I have no problem telling you what you can look at, where you can start. And it's on here. There's opportunities on here for you. All right, so Don't look back. Don't give up. Hold your head up. And see you guys next time. Peace.